Good afternoon, Selective. I'm going to do some painting today. I know that I'm very, very ranting with the painting, and I apologise for that, but listen, I only do my videos as to whatever it is I happen to be doing, okay? So, but I've already started this, obviously. Show you my subject. So this is just straight up oils on it's like a hard board. I'm doing it on a hard board because this person wants to put it into sort of like a frame, so this sits sort of sturdy. So anyway, that doesn't matter. So this is the basis of my subject. Obvious what it is. He likes his little Datsun Ute there. Then I've got another one of the face too. I won't show you because, you know, it's kind of like a bit of a privacy thing for that person. Obviously I've already started. I first primed it with a white, and then I've gone in and placed everything with the red and blue, and so it's a matter of finding the darks and the lights. In most of my paintings I usually only use the primary colours, red, yellow and blue, to create something, and then I just do variations of that, which I suppose everyone does really, because all colours are made of the three primary colours, right? Red, white and blue, plus white and black, in variations. So yeah, I suppose it's just a given. But anyway, shall I just get on with it? I've already obviously started. This is my palette with the red and the blue, and now I've got some yellow ochre, which I'm going to do next. So it's not like yellow. It's a yellow ochre. I've also used for the first couple of layers, I've only mixed it with a bit of Terps, and that makes it like thin, dry, and dries quickly. But now I'm going to start adding some medium, some fat medium. So I've got that here, and I just put a little tiny bit of Terps in just to sort of water it down. So as I do the layers, I have less Terps, and then it brings it up to a gloss. I might just throw it here. Just drag my palette over so that I can use it close and hold on to my image at the same time. Hang on, where am I going to go here? So I've got my thing here. So it's a matter of like each layer that I do, I'm breaking it down and I'm getting tighter and tighter on the image. This is a very blurry image, that's why I've got that other one, which is not so good either, but you know, I'll work with what I've got. That will stop me, that will prevent me from getting too fussy and tight as well. So, the third colour, this is just the yellow, that kind of ties the other colours together a bit. And that looks pretty. So I do it quite thin so that, you know, the darks and the lights shine through, right? And that each layer that you do, it, you know, it gets deeper and deeper. Yeah, I'm just sort of like rubbing it in, right? So that it's transparent. So it's only like a thin layer. It's not like a thick.
see what's going on. So with each layer I do the tighter it gets. I better ring my friend. He's just in the hospital yesterday. I'll do that. Do a little bit more here. Get the gist of what's going on.
one's northern.
Oh, okay, yes. Yes. That's beautiful. Oh, wow.
So you're here visiting today?
We've been here a couple of nights. We're going on tomorrow. We're just around. We're not on the bus or two, but we're in our caravan.
Yeah, getting out and seeing the world.
Trying to get around Australia. Trying.
You will.
Yeah.
Put your mind to it. Have you seen the wildflowers at the top of the hill here?
No.
So if you go up to the lookout.
Yes.
And you get to the, you can park your caravan where the big border tank is.
Yes.
And then you can walk to the next hill and there's lots of wildflowers up there.
Oh, wow.
It's very nice.
Oh, thank you. And who's this gentleman?
He's this person here. He's a friend of mine.
Yes.
So he
got it. Lovely. And you use a mixture here,
no?
You've got
So this is oils.
Yes.
Yep. And we'll just start off sort of mixing with turps to make a thin layer, and then as the layers go on, it gets tighter and tighter and it gets glossier.
Yes.
So I put more of the medium in as I go on.
You can feel the depth, you feel it.
Build up. Yeah, I mean, I'm still working on that, actually, that means more layers. I need to get back to it, give them all.
But do you need to give yourself a time scale? Or do you
think,
no, that's enough? I can't put anything in.
Yeah, and then I'll just leave it and I might go back to it a year later, you know.
And just think, oh, I just need to.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. When do you finish? When do you say, that's it? That's it?
That's an open question, really. Sometimes, these ones, I started off when I was going to get tight. I gave them more depth than that. They're going to be like, no, it's not. So, and that's just sporadic in there. So,
wow.
So it's loose, you know, in life.
Yes. Yeah, and it gives the fluidity. It gives it that.
Gives you the feel.
I never know where this person's going. That's how I feel.
Yeah.
She might be looking that way, but she's.
Yeah, she might be actually turning her head.
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh my goodness, that was quite a long pause. Anyway, I'm back and I made some sales. That was nice, right? And I got another commission, which is cool. I think I've unblocked, I had a block, I'm sure, of, you know, that energy flow, and I think I have broken the block. So anyway, let me finish off here for today. I'll just put a little bit more of this this yellow in. Oh, and I better ring my friend and make sure he's okay. He's just got out of hospital and I don't think he can walk, but so I better make sure he's got him. He's just he's a neighbour. I run into on my walks in the morning. Sometimes he walks his dog, and he's gone and done something to his leg. And I don't know who. I had to find somebody yesterday that was going to walk his dog. He's got this great big mastiff thing. I can't manage him. And because he's done his hurt his leg, he's going to need someone to walk the dog.
So, I'll just hang on. So what I'm actually doing there, what you can see that I'm doing, I'll show you close up here. So as I put this yellowing on, I'm making an edge. You can see how I make this edge, and it's going from like this dry looking paint. And then where this, it's got a little bit of gloss in it with the medium added to it, it kind of like creates I'm making that suggestion of that rolling of the panel there, right? And so when I come in with the next layer, the lines that I'm creating at this stage, the edge of that paint will pick up and make a stronger line. You understand what I'm saying? Here, so I'm just going to put in a bit of colour in here, and I'm going to make an edge. See how that, making that edge, when I put the next colour on it, it'll pick up. So yeah, being mindful of the lines that you're making with the brush, because the next layers that's going to pick up, because this has got the medium in it now. Like these other layers has only got the turfs, so it's sort of like a dry, flat surface. You can't feel the ridges on there, but with this, with the medium added to it, it's sort of like it gives a gloss and it gives a little bit of texture. So it's almost sculptural as you add the layers, right? To take painting around the edge as well, because it just gives it more of a finishing off, right? Now, a bit of colour in the background. I'll just get a bigger brush. This, oh damn. Right, let's come over here. So we're going to do, we're looking here now. So we're just putting a little bit of interest in the background. So we're just going to follow this. It's not going to be like a photographic thing, but I'm just going to like throw in some areas. throw that old car in there. Okay, I'm going to leave it there for the moment. So, I'll leave it there and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.